CBS News on the Hour, your home for original reporting.
I'm Lisa Mateo. The White House says people spreading vaccine lies over social media are responsible for the deaths of a growing number of Americans.
The number of people who are dying around the country because they're getting misinformation that is leading them to not take a vaccine.
Right.
Young people, old people, kids, children, this is all being, a lot of them are being impacted by misinformation.
Press Secretary Jen Psaki. The CDC says daily COVID deaths have increased 26%. In Los Angeles County, rising cases has prompted officials to reinstate an old restriction.
Los Angeles County is once again requiring everyone, vaccinated and unvaccinated, to wear masks indoors.
I don't like it. I'm vaccinated. I wish everybody else would get vaccinated, so it's a little frustrating.
LA County health officials say it's in response to the rise in cases due to the Delta variant, which is causing a surge in cases nationwide. But nearly all of the new cases are among the unvaccinated.
CBS News correspondent Henry Schuyler reporting. Catastrophic flooding has killed more than 125 people in Central Europe and left thousands homeless.
Emergency responders in Germany are still searching for missing people after the worst floods in living memory killed over 100 in the country's western regions. As the floodwaters started to recede on Friday, thousands of rescue workers, including 850 German soldiers, were taking part in the rescue mission. Over 1,300 people are still missing. Anna Noriskevich, CBS News, Berlin.
Things are heating up in Montana.
Record triple-digit temperatures have prompted excessive heat warnings across much of Montana, where winters are generally warmer and summers much hotter. Steve Running is a retired University of Montana climatologist.
We're seeing less of those cold extremes and more of these hot extremes. Of course, that's what the climate models forecast.
Air quality alerts are posted in the upper plains and upper Midwest because of smoke from western wildfires. Jim Crisula, CBS News.
Pfizer is paying up, and it has nothing to do with vaccines. The pharmaceutical company has agreed to a $345 million settlement over claims by consumers who say they overpaid for EpiPens. In a statement, Pfizer said it denies any wrongdoing and continues to believe that its actions were appropriate. And a Maryland woman is giving up her Uber Eats gig, and rightfully so. In between her deliveries, the mother of five scratched off a winning lottery ticket worth $250,000. She says she plans to settle some bills, put down a payment on a house, and help her children financially. She also chose to remain anonymous and go by the name Grateful Mom. You could say that again. On Wall Street, we have the Dow is up 300 points. This is CBS News.
Well, that's today's news. Today's news. I didn't hear any good news, did you? I didn't think so. I guess the cup is only half full. It's about perspective, isn't it? All right. Well, as always, I want to thank you for coming along with me on these dash cam news adventures. How do you like these houses around here? You need about a few million, not a couple, a few. This is Menlo Park, California. And if you look up the real estate prices around here, oh boy. I better get out of here because I can't afford it. I can afford to work here, but not to buy here. Well, all right. Let's see if my whistler's working. Bye-bye, everybody.